Namaste. You are welcome to our virtual class run by N-Person Kaski. Dear students, today we are learning social studies class 9. And unit 2, lesson 2. We are today learning the preconditions or the prior conditions of development. Means that while we are running the infrastructure of development, what conditions should be there? What sorts of circumstances should be there? And then, what is the prearly needed condition for the development? What should we have beforehand starting the development activities? If there is literacy in people, if there is peace and order in society, if there is the entrepreneurship in society, if there is a public participation in society, the development work should be durable one, development work should be sustainable one, and then it should be eco-friendly. And then the development activities should be democratic. And then under the basis of equity, under the basis of equality, we can launch the development activities. First of all, we should examine that where there is the prior conditions are available or not. If the prior condition of development are present there, the development will be successful. Then we can launch the development activity without any difficulty. That thing we are learning today. Yes, dear students, today's lesson is on prior condition for development. Prior means beforehand. Before starting something else, that is prior. Condition means the circumstances or the situation we need. What sort of situation we need beforehand launching the development activities? They are called the prior condition of the development. Means that while running the infrastructure of development, what sort of conditions should be there? Only then the development activities will be perfect and meaningful. We are learning here. Circumstances needed before starting executing sustainability of the work done. Means when we launch the activity, examining or the testing the prior condition, the development work goes smoothly. There is not any hurdle of the development. Development work will be durable one. The development work will be sustainable as well. Then the condition required durability and eco-friendliness in development means that for making the development eco-friendly, we need the things. We need the activities. They are called the prior condition, pre-basis. While running development activities, what should be there at first? They are called the prior conditions. Then the condition to be fulfilled beforehand. They all are about the introduction to the topic. Our topic is about prior condition of the development. If we are changing the people's life positively, we are running the infrastructure of development, what sort of circumstances should be there? What sort of situation is liked there in running the development? They are called the prior conditions of the development. Now, we are talking about the literacy. Literacy is the first hand needed activity, needed condition for the development. It is the prior condition of the development. Means where there is literacy, then development work will go on smoothly. There is no any difficulty in running the activity. Means that what is literacy? Saksharata in Nepali, ability to read, write and do the arithmetic calculation. It is the traditional definition of the or the very shortest definition of the literacy. Nowadays, in literacy, 7 R are necessary. They are reading, writing, rate of calculation, recreation, relation. These are the major materials, major things to be included in our activities. Only then we can say it is the literate one. If there is a literacy, people read and write, they think about their right and duties, they build up the relation among the society, they take part in recreational activities, there is reciprocity and there is mutual understanding, only then people take part in development activities and then they remove the ignorance in them. There is no any darkness made by the illiteracy or the traditional faith. Only then people support in development activities. Before running the development activities, what is needed there? Literacy is needed. When people are literate, they contribute in development activities. And then development activities will be successful and the meaningful as well. So literacy is the very most important material for the development one. Then when people are literate, they are adequate one. They develop the social amity and they develop the feeling of the civilization as well. So literacy plays the vital role in bringing the positivity in the society. And as we get people having skill, if such skill are in people, they are called literate one. If they have reading, writing, arithmetic, calculation, knowledge of rights, responsibility, relation, recreation, and then that is the perfect definition, that is the perfect qualities of the literate one. If people know to read, write, do simple calculation, and then they are none about the right and duties to be performed there, and they are totally none about the country's law, country's constitution, it's an everything, and then that is about the literate people. Then it is the perfection of the literacy. Now, if people are literate one, if people know about the right and duties, if they have the good relation among the people in society, and if they read newspaper, and then if they are concerned with the society as well, and they help the government, they criticize the government wrongdoings, and they participate in development activities, and they run their own business too. They make themselves self-dependent, and when they are self-dependent, when they stand on their activity as well, and they keep themselves away from the traditional belief and traditional thinking or misconception, and that helps in social amity and social friendly behavior. Now, we studied about the literacy. Literacy is important as a prior circumstances of the development. Now we are talking about the peace and order. It is another prior condition of the development. It is needed to run the development activities priorly. Without having peace in the society, peace in the country, we cannot launch the development activities freely. What does peace mean? Peace is free from violence. If there is not any disturbance, people are in mutual understanding, people help each other, and then if there is peace in society, development occurs ultimately. Then Here, the condition of social harmony and mutual respect, it is the definition of the peace. If people work together, and then if people mix together, and then if there is the feeling of mutual understanding, that is we call peace. Then violence-free exploitation, free environment means people are free, and then there is not any violence in the society, and that is the condition of peace. And peace and development are complementary to each other. Means where is peace, there is development. Without peace, development cannot be launched there. Means in peaceful environment, everything can be mobilized there and development may be possible. Then from the decision making to its ultimate effect, means everywhere, means while collecting the data of the problems and selection of the problems and making the decision over the problems and launching the their development activities and supervising it. And when people think they are under the development, their life is being changed. Until the time, if there is peace, there will be the success of the development. Then that is about peace and order. And what are essentially needed in peace? And what should be there in peace? What sort of conditions are required to make any place peaceful? First of all, good governance. If people are governing, if there is rule of law, and there is peace. If there is not rule of people, if the rule is made by people's representatives, if people can make and people can end the ruling system, only then there is peace. And then awareness and literacy. If people are literate, if they are aware about the result, about the effect, and then there is peace. Equality. If the means and resources of the state are equally distributed among the people, regardless of their origin and their geography, and there is peace. Mutual cooperation. There is no difference. There is no discrimination. People are having the facilities and they are working together, and only then their peace is managed. Political stability. And if there is the static ruling and the ruling party, it is launching the development activities freely there and until the tenure, and that is about the political stability, public participation. And these all, when people take part in development activities, if there is stable government and means and resources are equally distributed there, and if there is a rule of people, under it the peace can be germinated, peace can be developed. So these are the prior condition of the peace. Okay. We study today about the prior conditions of the development. What condition, what circumstances are required to develop a place? And then while launching the development activities, what conditions are needed beforehand? They are called the prior conditions. We learned about literacy. Literacy simply, it is the way or skill of knowing the calculation and reading and writing in the 21st era, and 7 hours are necessary for making anybody literate. They are reading, writing, rate of calculation, relation, recreation, and then rights and duties. And only then one can be totally a literate person. Then we read about peace there. Dear students, now I am drawing your attention towards the homework. Today's homework for you is the literacy changes the social appearance. Do we agree? Give reasons. Then I think you can do the work given. Second question is about how can peace be maintained in society. And these questions, I summarize it before, then you can do it well, thinking so. Thank you. Have a good day.